We're excited to start opening Tenny's collection, and here is Tenny herself in the brand new packaging. She retails for $115 at American Girl, but before we open her up, we want to show you the gifts that were given out at her release. Here it all is laid out. As you can see, it was quite a few things. We got an American Girl magazine, which it has a few DIYs in it, so that'll be really fun to browse and maybe craft for our dolls. It also came with two crafts that you can do right away. This is the guitar card, and you can fill in the blanks to create your own song. And then there is string right here, so you can thread it to make your guitar on the front. Cute! And then this is the banjo. So you open it up, again, you can fill out the blanks to create your own song. And the string hanging right here, you can create the banjo on the front. Here's a closer look at the words inside the craft. There were also special guitar cookies made for Tenny's release. However, ours were frosted brown, and a lot of the stores frosted them blue to match her guitar. It's the details. And in this Tenny Grant envelope is a doll t-shirt, and it's really cute. It's a beautiful color, and then on the front is Tenny and the guitar. On the back it is Velcro. And let's get a closer look at that. Adorable. So these were the items that they handed out at Tenny's release, and they did this at all the stores. Some of them did it on different days or at different times, and it was limited quantities. Okay, back to Tenny. We want to take her out of the box, but first, you will notice that she is in the new packaging, so you can see her whole outfit right through the front. And then on the back, there is a picture of her on her stage with her guitar. We'll get a closer look. So she is performing, and it has a little information about Tenny and the doll on the back of the box. Doesn't she look wonderful on stage? I love it. Can't wait to open her up. So here she is. I have not opened the box yet. I want you to see me opening the box. I've done this process with Gabriella because she had new packaging. And I also did it with Logan, and they were actually a little bit different as far as how they were put in the box. So we're gonna open her up and see if she's more like Gabriella or more like Logan. So the box is the same, and right away I can see that she is packaged like Gabriella. Her arms are secured on the side of the box. So if you see these strips right here, it's really easy to get her out of the box without damaging anything. So her neck is in a place, her ankles are in a place, and then her book is also secured in the box. And then don't miss this, on the bottom side of the box, she has a bracelet, and then right behind her is her book. So we're gonna get her out of this packaging without destroying the box, just in case we wanna put her back in the box later for storage or something. So what I'm gonna do is I'm only gonna cut one of the straps that holds her wrist into place, because the other strap can stay there, and the one strap I can just slip right over her wrist so I can take her out of the box. Very easy. Now I'm gonna repeat on the other side, just taking off one of the straps. All right, her arms are ready to be taken out, so now we're just gonna take off her neck elastic. You don't need scissors, just stick your finger right in between the elastic and you'll be able to pull it off the hooks. And then down by her ankles, elastic bands are right around her feet. So you'll just lift them up and over and your doll will be free. You can take her out now. She's not stuck in there. Oh, she got stuck. Oh, the hairnet got stuck on the hook. Let's get that off. Beautiful. All right, now that she is out of the box, we are going to take off her hairnet and get her ready for her big show. So take this hairnet off. Oh, and she has a little curl on the side that's not tucked in the hairnet. Cute. Take that hairnet off. And her curls are a little messy as soon as we take the hairnet off, but no big deal. We'll be able to fix those with our fingers in just a minute. So she has the curly blonde hair, freckles, and the brown eyes. Depending on the light, her eyes can look a little golden and they can also look a little reddish. Let's get a little closer. So her look to me, not her character, but her look reminds me of Rosalie Hale from the Twilight series, just because she has that blonde hair, she has that little freckle above her lip, and her eyes look so much like her, depending on the angle and the lighting, but she definitely reminds me of Rosalie's look. But her eyes are brown, it's just sometimes they give off this kind of weirdish glow. They do open and close, she has the freckles across her nose, the beauty mark right above her lip, and her lips are a little sparkly, they're definitely tinted. She has one loose curl on the side. She also has one twist in her hair on the other side. And she comes with her hair pulled back in a ponytail. But we're gonna take that elastic off in a little bit and let her curls loose. Her ears do not come pierced, but you can get them pierced at the doll salon for $16, and the music notes will be put in her ears. So that is a close-up of her eyes, her facial features, her beautiful blonde hair, a little bit of caramel in her hair, and the earrings that she comes with. So from top to bottom out of the box, this is what Tinny looks like. Now just like Logan, her bandmate, she does have a different hand mold than all the other American Girl dolls. This is so she can play her instruments. But what I really love about her new hand molds is, she can hold her guitar and her banjo, but she can also hold other things, which is really fun. We're gonna put her bracelet on her since she comes with this bracelet. It's a little tricky, you gotta be careful because it's super tight. There we go. Oh, we put it upside down. We'll fix that in a minute. We've taken off the outfit that she comes in, that way you can see her cloth body and what she looks like underneath. This is the original cloth body that all the other American Girls have. So her body is different from Logan's as far as the fabric. Here is a back view. As you can see, there are no neck strings, so she is a zip tie doll. And there are no panties sewn onto her. And when I reviewed Logan, I told you I would put him next to Tinny. So here they are side by side. So you can see the vinyl, their vinyl color is the same. However, their cloth bodies are different. So the shade is different and also the fabric is different. So she doesn't have a new cloth body, but I do think she has a new vinyl. It's a little bit softer. It's not too bad. You squeeze her arm, it's not that much of a give, or her cheeks, but if you squeeze up here near her temples, yeah, you might not want to do that. I mean, I don't think this is going to affect play because typically we don't squeeze our dolls' heads during play, but I just wanted to show you that it is a softer vinyl. You don't want to do that. You're going to pop their eyes out or something. I just wanted to show you how soft it is, and I'm not using that much force on her face. So I don't recommend squeezing your doll's head. You don't want her to end up cross-eyed. Here is her outfit that she comes in. As you can see, she doesn't have the perma panties. Her panties do come off. They're elastic. They're the normal pink panties. And I don't know if in the future she will have sewn-on panties, but for now she doesn't. Here is her meat shirt. It velcros in the back. Has a little bird on there, and it has a front tie. Sing your story. Over her t-shirt, she wears this denim vest, which is really cute. I think it's totally in style right now. There's a little design right here that's sewn on. Cute. The little buttons have stars on them and the pockets don't open and there's no Velcro on this item. Here is her skirt. It's a faux leather skirt and it does have a design on it. Let's see if you can see that. And it's pleated on the front. So it says American Girl on the bottom. It's pleated, it has a little design in the leather, and it's elastic. So you'll be able to just fit it right over your doll. There is no stitching at the bottom of the skirt right here. Y'all always ask about that. No stitching right there. It's just cut straight. And last are her little ankle boots. They are brown, which they are two-tone brown. You have the dark brown and the light brown. And they Velcro on the side. That way you can slip it right over her foot. She does not come with any socks or anything, so just goes straight on the foot. And I'm not sure what it's made of, but I'm scratching it and it's not leaving a mark, so that's good. The next item in her collection that we want to open is her dog. She has a golden retriever. His name is Waylon. Pretty sure that's how you pronounce it. Yeah, Waylon. He retails for $24. And before we open him up and move on to how fun he is and cuddly, I want you to notice something on his box. You see the flower, you see the bird, and those items come in Tinny's earring set. The earrings are $16 and you do get your doll's ears pierced. All three of these items are throughout her whole collection on all the packaging, and they are also Gabriella's earrings. So when you get Gabriella's ears pierced, you get the exact same set. Okay, back to her dog. This is Waylon, and he is Tinny's biggest fan. He has soft brown fur, and if you can see these flowers, they are attached to his collar. Yes, even though it's a male dog, he has little flowers on his collar to match Tinny, of course. And this blue collar is attached to his body, so you can't take the leash off. It's connected, so you'll have to wrap it up and stick it in his collar if you want to take pictures without the leash. So there he is, and he is in a sitting position waiting for Tinny. Next are Tinny's accessories, and they retail for $34, but you do get a $5 discount if you buy her accessories with the doll. So we're gonna open this up because, again, this is the new packaging, so I wanna show you guys what it looks like when you take it out of the box. So you'll open it up, and you just pull out the guitar. So no tissue paper again, but it is packaged nice and safe. So here's the guitar. You also get a journal and you get a pick. So with her journal, it has flowers on it, totally country. So cute. So you can write your own notes in there and journal entries or write your own songs. Her name is in the book, but the first two pages already have a song jotted down. So it's really, really cool for Tinny. So if you want to keep writing songs, you can use this little journal. And for Tinny to play the guitar, she needs a pick. So it comes with a cute little pick. And as you can see, it's a little bit different because she's actually able to hold it, which is why she has different hand molds. And this is the guitar. These move, so they do spin. Let's get close. And the brand of this guitar is Taylor. You can see I am tuning the guitar right now. So very realistic. It's adorable. Love the flower details, love the blue on it. There's an outlet right here, a little plug-in. You can plug the amplifier into it from her stage set. And if you add batteries to this guitar, it plays three songs for you. And it can also be strummed with your pick. Look at that. That's adorable. So if you know how to play the guitar, I bet you could play a few tunes on this. I'm loving this. So that is fun. So it plays three songs, but you can also play it with the pick. Comes with this adorable strap, which you can take the strap off on the bottom hook and on the top. So you can hang this on the wall for decoration in Tinny's room, or you can put it around her and she can hold it using the strap. So that is Tinny's accessory set. Tinny's pajamas are $24 and they do come in the new packaging. So we're gonna take these out and see how they are attached. All right, so as I flip these over, I notice there are no strings, no stitches on the back of the cardboard box. So I think we're in good hands. So we'll just tug at the pajama shirt, and it is connected to the box. There's like a cardboard hanger on the back of the box, And that is it. Ta-da! No cutting involved there. And then here is her headband so she can pull her hair out of her face when she goes to sleep. And there is this plastic packaging across the front of the box. However, I'm not gonna cut it off. I'm just gonna lift up on it and take her little slippers out. They are not connected. And then her pajama shorts, same thing. They're just hanging on the cardboard hanger. No cutting necessary. These are her cute little slippers. They are adorable. And they are her moccasin slippers. I used to have a brown pair just like this, and they were my favorite. Here is the headband, very simple. These are her shorts, elastic waist, and ruffles at the bottom. Her pajama shirt does not have Velcro, so you do have to unbutton it and rebutton it. And it is long sleeves. And it has the floral design through it on top of the gingham pattern. I think her pajamas are adorable and I love it, and I think it totally just looks like Tinny. Now this is Tinny's picnic outfit, and it's a casual outfit, so that's a lot of fun. It retails for $28. And again, we're gonna take it out of the packaging because it's the new style and we wanna see if it's stitched into the box or not, just like the pajamas. So we're just gonna slide it out of the box. Hopefully it's the same. So we'll just remove the shirt from the cardboard hanger. And that is it. Voila, yay, no stitching. This is a cute style chambray shirt. Her pocket is really cute. The front buttons aren't real. It's a Velcro front and her sleeves are rolled up. Definitely a cute style. And then her shoes come right out of the packaging. They're not sewn into the box, so you can just lift up on the plastic again and they come out. These are little tan loafers, little velvet ribbons on them or laces. And then her shorts, again, they just come right off the cardboard hanger and they are not sewn into the box. This style crocheted shorts are really popular right now. You'll see them in all different colors. So it's definitely cute and a lot of people have these. And again, the packaging was good. Nothing left holes and it was not stitched in. This is Tinny's spotlight outfit, so it's nice and sparkly. It retails for $36. Hopefully we're gonna slide this right out of the box and off the cardboard hangers just like the others. Oh, got stuck somehow. Oh, right there on the back. There we go. So first we see her little headband and it just slides right out. It has three stars on it and it's sparkly and it's the same material as what's on her boots. So it definitely pulls the outfit together. And speaking of her boots, again, you can just lift up on the plastic packaging and the boots will slide right out. You can also cut that packaging. You don't have to slide it out like I did. These boots, wow. They're brown boots, but man, they are shimmery. Even the bottoms are adorable. You're not gonna see these, but they are cute. These boots are just sparkly. We love sparkle. They're definitely cowboy boots. They Velcro in the back, and Tinny is gonna look fantastic on stage in those boots. All right, so let's get the skirt out. Let's see if it just pulls off of the cardboard hanger. So far, so good. Yep, just slides right out. This is her pink shimmery skirt. It is very sparkly. It's gonna look great on the stage lights. It's elastic, looks like a little tutu. And now for the shirt, the last thing. Let's see. So the shoulders come off the cardboard hanger, but it felt stuck. Oh no, there's stitching on the back. So what I'm gonna do is very carefully, I'm gonna cut the stitching from the back of the box. I'm not gonna go through the front because I don't wanna cut anywhere near or close to the fabric. You risk accidentally cutting your shirt and we don't wanna do that. So I'm just gonna make sure the stitching is cut on the back of the box. Then I'm gonna turn it around and very carefully, I'm going to take it off of the box. There we go. So all the outfits so far were good. This was the only thing that was stitched in. So what I want to do is look very closely at the shirt where it was stitched, because with Gabriella's pajamas, there were holes left behind that were very noticeable. So we're going to look really carefully. You can kind of see where the stitching was on the inside of the shirt. Not as bad as Gabriella's pajamas. But on the front, you definitely cannot tell that it was stitched in any way. You can't see any of the holes just because it's a lacy shirt and it went through the lace. So that is Tenny's spotlight outfit, and it's adorable. We love it. To add to Tenny's picnic outfit, you have Tenny's hat and necklace set. This retails for $18. And you can get it by itself and throw it on with a few different outfits, which is totally doable, but it's also really cute with her picnic outfit. The hat ties into the belt on that outfit, so let's open it up and see how it's packaged. This is the first look into the box. Kind of sad I missed that tissue paper, but at least the hat is not squished in any way, and the necklace is in a little plastic baggie. The necklace is on a string that you can adjust for the doll, and it comes with a little pick that has a G on it, a pick charm, and a bird on the back of the pick. Here is her floppy hat. Kind of want to craft this. I just have a feeling we can do this. It's so cute. I think this material is a wool and a braided faux leather trim. Now, Tenny doesn't just play the guitar, she also plays the banjo, which you can get for $28. This set comes with the banjo, the strap, and the thumb pick. Now, these do twist just like they did on the guitar. There isn't a name brand on this one. Just her flowers are on the banjo. But it does play music. You can add batteries to it and it plays a few songs. But you can also use this thumb pick, which I don't know how to play the banjo, so I don't know which way I'm supposed to use this. But it does make music. The strap is a beautiful metallic rose gold. And just like the guitar, you can take it off so it comes off. That way you can put it around the doll and then snap it back into place. On the back is where you add the batteries, and there's the on-off button. And then on the side is where you push the button to play the music. So the pre-recorded songs that are in there, you can press it and it'll play. So that is Tenny's collection so far. Give this video a thumbs up if you want to see us open her stage, and leave us a comment with ideas of things we can craft for Tenny.